the phobias, Batman. Like, all of the phobias. Hey, Twisted People, it's your Twisted Woman here, Chauncey K. Robinson, and today I am doing a spoiler-free review of the Netflix survival thriller, Oxygen. Oxygen is a French survival thriller. The film tells the story of a young woman who wakes up in a cryogenic pod. She doesn't remember who she is or how she ended up there. As she's running out of oxygen, she must rebuild her memory to find a way out of her nightmare. Oxygen does a lot with a little, although it is about 30 minutes too long. It keeps the anxiety high enough that will keep you on the edge of your seat all the way until the very last breath. This film plays on a lot of well-known phobias that get to a lot of people, whether it's being buried alive, being caught in a small space and you can't really move, you don't know what's going on, aka claustrophobia, all types of things, running out of air, all types of things. And I love the fact that it plays on these fears that are so basic. You know, so many people have this fear of the dark, fear of things that can seem very simple yet terrifying, right? And what Oxygen does is that it plays on that throughout the whole entire hour and 47 minutes. It does a lot with a little. All of the plot, or pretty much about 95% of the plot, takes place in this cryogenic unit. You are there with the main character, and she very much carries this film, and a lot rides on her and you as the audience member really feeling the terror that she feels of not knowing who she is, why she's there. Is she buried alive? Is she just stuck in some space? And on top of that, she's on a time clock because her oxygen, aka the title, is running out. And I was actually quite happy with that because I remember this actress from Inglourious Basterds and I loved her in this film. And so I was pretty much very confident that she would hold her own in this movie, but that was an ensemble cast. And this one, she is pretty much your sole person there. And she definitely does a great job. And you will feel, I think, you know, a connection to her. And you have to, right? This is a film that's all about the fear of this woman waking up in this cryogenic unit. And you basically going on the journey with her as she tries to figure out, how the heck do I get out of here? Or at least how I got here in the first place. So you don't have to wait too long for you to get to the guts of things. With that said, I do feel like it runs a bit longer than it needs to. This film is an hour and 47 minutes long. I feel like it could have been about an hour and 20 minutes or so, maybe even an hour and 15. Although the acting really keeps you on the edge of your seat and the idea that you are running out of time and the way that it is situated, I do feel like after a certain point, there are lulls in the way the story unfolds. And so it can feel a little bit repetitive. And of course, because the majority of this plot takes place in one spot. And the way that you distract the audience from the fact that this is all happening in one very small space is the terror of the situation. And it does a good enough job with that. But there are times, I think, and this is because of the fact that it runs as long as it does, where it's not going to be able to withstand that the whole entire time. And there are moments in there. And that's why I think it could have cut off about 20 minutes of this film in those moments. This is quality storytelling. It starts off with a very simple situation, a survival situation, but then it has a way in the second and third act of taking twists and turns that open it up to a way bigger story than I was expecting it to have. And so I appreciated that twist. I appreciated being drawn into maybe a little bit of a bigger world building from the likes of this small cryogenic pod. Is it scary? It's a scientific survival thriller, right? And so there are moments where there is terror, there is genuine terror that you would feel. Like I said, because the actress does such a great job of making you feel what she's feeling and going through what she's going through, that you have these moments where the stakes are high and you will feel that. Now, are there jump scares? There's probably one that attempts to be a jump scare, but I don't really think it is as scary unless, because this jump scare actually plays into yet another phobia that someone might have. If you have that phobia, without me spoiling it, you will probably jump. But I feel like this movie, when it comes to the horror element, when it comes to the fear element, it really does play on the situation that this character finds themselves in and what they have to do. That's where the terror is. It's not jump scare terror. It's the terror of you as the viewer having to witness something that can be so cringe when it comes to what this character is going through, when it comes to being stuck into this pod as the oxygen starts to run out. I also appreciated how, and I do think this is sort of a thing when it comes to sci-fi, of asking the question of existence, of what it means of humanity. That's in there as well, what it means to be alive, what it means to fear death and things like that in situations like that and the world that it builds around things. It hits a bit close to home in certain socio situations that we in this world have found ourselves in. And I thought it did a very good job of that without necessarily making it so that it overtook the very straightforward plot of being a survival thriller. The main trigger here is that there are moments where animals are in distress. And that happens a couple of times throughout, where if you are an animal lover like I am, then it does make you a little bit uncomfortable. I don't think it's done gratuitously, where it's like kind of in bad taste. I think it's there to be symbolic, and it's done in a way that it fits with the plot line. I didn't look at it and like, oh my gosh, you had to throw this in. It actually makes a lot of sense. My final twisted grade for Oxygen is a B+. Let me know in the comment section some of your phobias, some movies that play on a phobia that you may have or that you know plenty of people have. Let me know. Comment down below. And also be sure to subscribe so that you are the first to know when I post my videos. Thanks for watching. Let's get creepy together.